Hello, my name is Xu. In this video, I want to show you how to take smart notes in Rome. This personal knowledge management system is based on the Zettelkasten method, which is developed by a German sociologist, Niklas Luhmann. I explained this method in detail in my previous video, so if you haven't watched it, you should check it out. The process of the Zettelkasten method is very simple. First, you take a literature note, then you take a reference note, and transform them into permanent notes. So let's start from the step one. The first step is taking literature notes. They are basically the information you don't want to forget or think you use later in your writing or thinking. But there are two rules you should follow. One, it should be brief so that it's easy to review later. And two, you have to write it in your own words. This means no quoting. Copy and pasting is easy, but rewriting in your own words forces you to really understand what you're reading. If you're reading a physical book, take note of information you don't want to forget in Rome. Simply create a page for the book and start writing. If you're reading on Kindle, you can do the same thing, take notes while reading. But if you're like me, who don't want to take notes while reading, just highlight text. And when you finish reading, import the highlights into Evernote or OneNote using email. Alternatively, you can go to your Kindle website and copy your highlights from there. Once you copy the highlights, paste them in your book page. Then you can start taking literature notes while going through each highlight. And if you want to quote or want to remember where you got your idea from, simply use block reference using alt drag. This way, you can always come back to the source. Again, I have to remind you, these notes should be brief, and they have to be in your own words, no copy and pasting. This is a very simple step. All you have to do is make a reference note at the top of your page when you finish reading a book or article. It's just the author and a brief note about the content. Creating a permanent note is the most important step in the Zettelkasten method. They are the notes that become part of your mental models. Simply go through each note you made in the previous step while thinking about how they relate to what you already know. Try to find the connections between each note and your interests, learning, research, and thinking. Your goal is not collecting as many notes as possible, but it's adding new values to your existing ideas, arguments, and discussions. And if you think some of the notes can meet that criteria, transform them into permanent notes. In order to do that, just create a page for the idea. At the top of the page, write reference information. I usually write source, keywords, and relevant notes. Source is straightforward, it's just where you got the idea from, so in this case, it's a great mental model by Shane Parrish. Now, finding keywords and relevant notes is the most important process when you're making permanent notes. This is because learning is about connecting information. As Sonke Afren says, learning is not so much about saving information, like on hard disk, but about building connections and bridges between pieces of information. It is about making sure that the right cues trigger the right memory, about how we can think strategically to remember the most useful information when we need it. This is also why Rome is a great learning tool. It makes it so easy to find connections among pieces of your knowledge. So how do you do that? You have to find keywords and relevant notes. Keyword is like a tag, but a typical mistake people make when finding keyword is asking which keyword is most fitting, or what categories does this note fall into? Instead, you should ask yourself, in which circumstances would I want to stumble upon this note? Or when and how will I use this idea? For example, in this case, if you think about categories, it might be like productivity, but it's more likely that I search for specific phrases like how to journal, feedback, or how to get feedbacks. Finding relevant notes is as important as finding keywords. Niklas Luhmann always wrote links to relevant notes on his permanent notes. By finding relevant notes, you can build connections, which is a core of learning. To find relevant notes, open your permanent notes page in the sidebar using shift click. Go through each note to find relevant notes. And if you need, you can filter them using keywords. Finally, you can start writing your notes, but make sure you write in a proper sentence, not like bullet points. It has to be sentences you can actually use in your article or essay as they are. And before we go, don't forget to add permanent note tag next to the keywords. This allows you to see the list of your permanent notes in one place with the keywords. This is great because you can see your knowledge growing day by day. Also, you can use filter to see clusters of your interest. So for me, I can see that I'm interested in learning, education, life lessons, writing, and so on. And when you need to find a topic to write about, just come to this page and see the clusters you developed. Then you can easily write about them because you already have tons of information in your permanent notes. You may be thinking, this is an unnecessarily long process. Yes, that's true, it takes time. But learning is supposed to take time and effort. You can't just import highlights to Evernote and expect your brain to understand everything. You have to work for it. You have to think to understand. And writing is the best facilitator of thinking. Thank you so much for watching. Please let me know what you think about this method in the comments or Twitter or Instagram. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.